Unmanned ground and sea vehicles are the waves of the future, and it looks like that future might be here sooner than we think. This is Glenn, and today we are bringing you 10 unmanned ground and sea vehicles made for our future.
Number 10.
Designed by Daniel Simon, who worked on vehicles in films like Oblivion, Captain America, and Tron Legacy, the Robocar is a self-driving race car that relies on a mixture of radars, LIDARs, optical systems, and ultrasonic sensors for navigation. Made with improved aerodynamic efficiency, the car has a length of 15 feet 8 inches, a width of 6 feet 7 inches, and weighs almost 3,000 pounds. Four 135-kilowatt electric motors produce over 500 horsepower using a 58-kilowatt-hour battery, giving the Robocar an estimated top speed of more than 190 miles per hour. The Robocar is the first autonomous electric race car to have completed the hill climb at Goodwood and is set to compete in the Roborace in early 2019. Roborace is made to develop autonomous cars and will have teams compete by adding artificial intelligence to a Roborace-supplied application programming interface platform.
Number 9.
The Probot V2 unmanned ground vehicle, manufactured by RoboTeam, is an improved version of the original Probot UGV, with updated software and new batteries. Thanks to this, the independence of the robot has significantly improved, and it can work without recharging for 72 hours, instead of 10 for the previous version. With the 1,543-pound payload capacity, Probot can remotely evacuate multiple casualties to keep law enforcement and safety officials out of harm's way. Using 360-degree daytime and NIR cameras and optional environmental sensors, Probot provides real-time long-range intelligence gathering. This auxiliary vehicle has a length of 4 feet 9 inches, a width of 4 feet 2 inches, a height of 2 feet 2 inches, and a weight of about 2,200 pounds. The Probot has an all-weather controller with an easy-to-master user interface that can be used by a single person to control several unmanned vehicles in any lighting.
Number 8.
Uber's self-driving semi-truck OTTO works on any semi-truck with an automatic transmission and has three LiDAR laser detection units on the cab and trailer, a high-precision camera above the windshield, and a radar on the front bumper. Right now, the truck only works on the highway, where it can safely change lanes, maintain a safe following distance, and not have to worry about four-way stops, pedestrians, parking, or turning tight corners. Uber is focusing on the basics, like improving lane control and smoothing out the acceleration and braking, while long-term goals include navigating construction zones, dealing with hazards like sudden weather, and predicting how other drivers are likely to behave. Uber has since shut down the project so they can concentrate on improving their line of self-driving cars after an accident led to the death of a pedestrian.
Number 7.
Komatsu's 320 U.S. ton capacity 930E4, the world's best-selling ultra-class mining truck, is designed for rapid and efficient loading. This has a length of 51 feet, a height of 24 feet, and has an empty weight of 232 U.S. tons. Komatsu is the first manufacturer in the world to commercialize autonomous haulage systems, which allows for unmanned operation of these mining trucks in the mining industry. Each autonomous dump truck is equipped with an obstacle detection system and a wireless network system, a high-precision GPS system, and vehicle controllers. These features allow the dump truck to operate through a complex load, haul, and dump cycle, and to integrate with the loaders, dozers, and shovels that are also part of the autonomous system. Key benefits of unmanned operation include increased safety, a reduced number of workers, reduced operating costs, increased productivity and efficiency, and reduced fuel consumption and emissions.
Number 6.
Developed for Norwegian airport operator Avinor, the Yeti project is the first to adapt large machines for autonomous operation in wintry conditions. The technology developed by Semcon is making snow clearing possible at places like Fagernes Airport, where the project was first tested last winter. In winter 2018, these snowplows can prove what they can do, with two of them going into live operation at Oslo Airport, one of the busiest airports in Scandinavia. Autonomous snow clearing will allow airports all over the world to streamline their activities and reduce delays for their passengers. John Emil Halden, project manager at Semcon, has said that the aim is to complete 40 operations and ensure that the system is working correctly. The final objective is to maintain a fleet of 10 snowplows, keeping runways clear of snow and the airport running smoothly as the weather begins to challenge airport operations.
Number 5.
The Rheinmetall Mission Master is an unmanned ground vehicle that performs various surveillance and protection duties using a variety of modular payloads to get into dangerous and hard-to-reach areas. This will help alleviate soldier loads, which will lead to a lighter and more effective ground force. This 8-wheel multi-mission vehicle has high-speed capabilities and power to cross over any type of terrain, while a flexible storage system can be conveniently adjusted for high or low-profile operations, and its sturdy design can carry more than a half-ton payload of supplies, equipment, or other materials. There are two other variants of the Mission Master, including the surveillance variant, which is designed explicitly for perimeter observation, surveillance, and scout tasks, while the protection variant is designed for perimeter protection, escorting, target acquisition, and engagement tasks.
Number 4.
Designed in Israel for a range of defense and homeland security missions, Rambo can participate in a variety of missions such as strategic facilities and border defense, intelligence gathering, logistical supply, and ground warfare with limited risk to personnel. The Rambo is powered by a unique electrical drive system with automatic obstacle detection and avoidance. Riding on 6 independent wheels, this has a rear bay for storage and a forward mount that can carry a remote-controlled weapon station. This has a payload capacity of 1 ton, a length of 12 feet, a width of 7 feet 2 inches, a gross vehicle weight of 7,716 pounds, and a maximum range of up to 99 miles with a top speed of 31 miles per hour. This UGV also provides the operator with live video using onboard cameras and a long-range electro-optical camera that is mounted on a telescopic mast.
Number 3.
A collaboration between DARPA and the Navy, Seahunter is an unmanned drone ship designed by Leidos, a Virginia-based defense company. It was christened in 2016 and was just added to the Navy fleet after open water tests. The Seahunter is currently just for surveillance. It has no weapons on board. It's 127 feet long, has a top speed of 27 knots. Using cameras and radar for tracking and spotting other ships, the Navy hopes this will be able to stay out at sea for months at a time without the need of a crew. Named for the mission the Navy envisions for it, stalking foreign submarines at sea, the Seahunter could be fitted for weapons in the future, but there would always be a human at the controls. Costing $20 million, this is relatively cheap to build and far less expensive to run than similar human-crewed vessels.
Number 2.
NAVYA and Keoly Canada announced Canada's first long-duration autonomous shuttle pilot project, beginning at the end of August in the city of Candiac near Montreal, and it will operate in real traffic conditions for 12 months. Capable of transporting up to 15 people, 11 sitting and 4 standing, the shuttle has a length of 15 feet 7 inches, a width of 7 feet, a height of 8 feet 8 inches, and an empty weight of 5,300 pounds. With an operating speed of 15 miles per hour, the shuttle is designed to optimize navigation and safety features with neither a steering wheel nor pedals, while using effective guidance and detection systems that combine several types of advanced technology. The route includes several stops that meet mobility needs of the city and passengers and has several advantages that improve road congestion and make trips more enjoyable during morning and evening work commutes.
Number 1.
Another driverless vehicle produced by NAVYA is the AUTONOM cab, which was designed to be autonomous right from the beginning with no cockpit, steering wheel, or pedals. Carrying 1 to 6 passengers, the cab is fully connected to technology with onboard Wi-Fi and a bunch of safety sensors, including 10 LiDAR sensors, 2 GNSS antennae, 6 cameras, 4 radar, and 1 inertial measurement unit. This will be the first autonomous cab on the market, providing either a private or shared service with an emphasis on hospitality or comfort. This also has an operating speed of 30 miles per hour and a top speed of 55 miles per hour.
Hey guys, this is Cassie. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Tell us in the comments below what you found to be the most interesting and why. Also, if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the bell notification next to the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.